All right, everybody, I'm going to show you how to play PS5 games with your Dualshock 4. We got Black Ops Cold War. Let's press start. Got the back button and everything. As you said, you cannot play PS5 games with your Dualshock 4, but there's a workaround for that. So let me turn off the controller. Go into our launcher here. That's how you turn off your controller. Go to Dualshock 4. It's compatible because you see the name. I'm going to turn it off. Now, let's head over to our computer. Yes, we're doing this method. So let's hit our share buttons because it's off. Make sure you turn it off first. Pair it up. Actually, it paired with the console. Hold on 1 second. I didn't do it right. So turn it off again. 1 second. So we hold our share button. Hold down our PlayStation button to start sharing. There we go. And on our Apple computer, let me delete this so it can appear again. We're going to connect it. And once we connect it, open up our remote play. Make sure you sign into your PSN account. Open this up. And it's going to search the console because it's on the same internet connection. That's a little loud. Shouldn't turn that down. And now, same connection, it's wireless too. I can use the back button still. See? Select the game because I had this set to X. Black Ops Cold War. That's right, we're doing it. See? I know it's not directly on your Xbox, on your PS5, but you can play. Let's play some bots. And this is the PS5 version. I'm going to show you. Let's check in our settings because in the graphics settings. 1 second, in the back buttons. Well, you see, we have the 120Hz mode and ray tracing. So this is definitely the PS5 version. You want to have that. And let's play some games in the lobby of your bots. But yeah, it works, you know. Set up your PS and back button if you still got controls like that. See, pop it on. See, I got X and zero, X and O. Yeah, that's really, I'm playing the game. Control it. Skip the scene. How you do that? I'm telling you. Back button working too, see? No press nothing. No smoke and mirrors. This is how you do it, and you can do it wirelessly. So just have your computer screen off in the background. And if you have your controller, got used to the PS4, and all that. Wow, it's so hard to play like that. Buttons work, so let's see what happens. Yeah, your share button works. Can't take a screenshot now? Yeah. So this is how you use your PS4 controller and PS5 games. I hope this helped you out. I'll see you guys later. Alright everybody, I got my PS4 controller connected to my Windows PC. The light on. And to check it with the Bluetooth drivers, PS4 controller, nothing works. Nope. Unfortunately, on Mac, you can do this with wirelessly, but on Windows, you gotta plug in that controller. And the light turns blue, and you got custom games and stuff. You can hit the back buttons too. They still work like that. That's cool. They still work. And to check out the settings, that's a PS5 controller. And like you say, you get the HDR and 120Hz. So it still works like that, but you just have to plug it in on one of those computers. So just one last update. I boot camp my Mac and let's check out, let's pair our wireless controller. White light, ready to go. I have my remote play all downloaded. Nothing works. Wow. So the Mac, if you want to do this wirelessly, you need a Mac computer. I don't know why I don't work on Windows. Let's plug it up. You gotta get this adapter since it's all USB-C. Yep, game works. Back buttons, all that. The game works. So, Windows is wired, Mac is wired, or wireless. So, if you have a Mac computer, well, it goes well with your PS5. That's all I want to say. So this name was Sky Dragon. I hope this video still helps you out. Unfortunately, Windows, you have to plug it in. I don't know what's wrong with Windows. Well, this is Windows 10 for both of them, just to make sure. All right.